Welcome to Level Up. In this show, we will show you how to hands-on build useful solutions with Google Cloud Services. And today we actually have a special episode. My good friend and teammate TTH is here. He's a solution architect in Google Cloud like myself. We are in the same team. So let's bring him on. TTH, welcome. Good to see you, man.
Good to see you. Thanks for having me.
What have you been building recently?
So recently, I've been experimenting with using Google Cloud's serverless offerings to build a full serverless infrastructure that monitors events that are happening in Google Cloud and automatically pushes notifications about these events to my mobile phone or chat app.
Can you build it for us?
No problem. Let's do it live in real time right now. Let's begin by going to Hangouts Chat. So in Hangouts Chat here, we have already created a chat room beforehand, and this is where our notifications will be sent to.
So you could make a chat room just for your own app, for example, or own system, and just notify you.
Exactly. Or I could send it to a chat room with a bunch of other people inside so that everyone knows what's happening to our resources. To begin, let's create a webhook. And here we'll need to copy our URL as you'll be using it further down the road.
So that's basically a signed secure URL, but it's a public URL. And that's what the other system is going to be calling then to publish to this chat room, right?
Exactly. So our cloud function will be using the URL to publish notifications later. Now we are going to preset some environment variables. Here we are choosing to use US Central 1 and US Central 1A for our default region and zone.
And because you're using environment variables, you could basically script it also and automate the whole thing, right? Creation.
Yes, we could automate this process entirely using an automated workflow or a pipeline. Here, we are setting a few other environment variables. We are setting the name of our project. We are predefining the name of the part subtopic that we'll be creating, as well as what we are going to call our disk. In addition, we are going to populate the webhook URL environment variable with the webhook that we have created previously in the chat room.
Who's going to be monitoring these events? So what system notices that this event is happening?
So we'll be creating a Stackdriver export to monitor these events further down the road, and we'll be doing that now, actually. The next piece that we are going to be creating is our pub subtopic. And if we go to the UI, we can see that the pub subtopic has been created. Over here, you can see that it's called GCE Snapshots Events.
And right now it's triggered by these disk events, but it could be any event in your Google Cloud environment, right?
Exactly. It could be any event that we are interested in that creates a log message. Now that we have created our pub subtopic, we are going to create a logging sync. Now what this logging sync does is that it keeps a lookout for any log messages regarding our disk snapshot and whether it has been successfully created. And the moment once these messages appear, this logging sync will push a message to our pub subtopic. After this logging sync has been created, make sure to take a note of the corresponding service account over here, as you'll be needing this for our next step.
And with the service account, you basically give permissions to this piece of automated software, in this case, to be able to execute what it needs to do, like publish messages, but nothing else, right?
Yes, so that keeps our entire infrastructure secure, because only this service account will have the permissions to publish messages to our pub subtopic. So here, we are giving our service account the required permission to publish to our topic. The next thing we are going to do is to deploy our cloud function, which will look at our topic and push a notification to our chat app whenever there's a message in the topic.
All right. That's going to take a while, right?
Yep, that's going to take a little bit of time.
Cool. Still going?
Still going, we just started.
All right. How is it?
Still going, it's not going to change no matter how many times you ask me.
Cool. Still going?
Almost done. we have successfully deployed our cloud function.
Sweet.
If you look at the UI here, you can see that indeed we have successfully deployed our cloud function here, which is called push events to webhook. Now, that means that we are pretty much done in setting up our entire serverless infrastructure. What we are going to do next is to actually test our setup. Here, we are going to create a new disk in Google Cloud to test our infrastructure. So if you look here, we have created a disk already. Next, we are going to manually trigger taking a disk snapshot of the disk that we have created previously.
All right. And the snapshot is going to take a while too?
Yep, that's going to take a little while.
Cool.
And the snapshot is complete. If we look in the snapshots section, you will see that the snapshot appears here. Yeah. Also, if our infrastructure is working as intended, I should be able to go to my chat application and see that a notification has been pushed to me.
All right, that's great. It actually looks very easy and handy and fast to do, so I think I will be using it myself. So if any of our viewers want to follow these steps themselves and repeat them, how would they go about doing this?
I'm glad you asked, because the code for everything that we have done today is available on GitHub right now. And you can find the link to the repository down in the description below.
Very good. Thank you for today, TTH. It's really nice content.
Thank you. Happy to be here.
And if you like this content, click the like button, click subscribe, and be notified of our new episodes. And see you next time. Thank you and bye-bye.